डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिविटी ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशन ओवर एडिशन, डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिविटी ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशन ओवर एडिशन. सी दिस एग्जाम्पल, सिक्स इन टू, इन टू मीन्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन. फाइव प्लस थ्री, फाइव प्लस थ्री इज हियर, प्लस रिफर्स टू एडिशन. डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिविटी मीन्स सिक्स इंटू फाइव प्लस थ्री इज इक्वल टू सिक्स इंटू फाइव प्लस सिक्स इंटू थ्री. दिस प्रॉपर्टी इज कॉल्ड एज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिविटी ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशन ओवर एडिशन. नेक्स्ट आइडेंटिटी, वी विल चेक इट आउट फॉर एडिशन एज वेल एज फॉर मल्टीप्लिकेशन. जीरो इज द एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी, दैट मीन्स सेवन प्लस जीरो इज इक्वल टू सेवन, फाइव प्लस जीरो इज इक्वल टू फाइव. वेन एवर वी आर गोइंग टू ऐड एनी नंबर विथ जीरो, वी विल गेट द सेम नंबर. ओके, दैट मीन्स हियर जीरो इज एक्टिंग एज एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी. जीरो प्लस फिफ्टीन इज इक्वल टू फिफ्टीन, जीरो प्लस ट्वेंटी सिक्स इज इक्वल टू ट्वेंटी सिक्स. दैट मीन्स जीरो प्लस समथिंग इज इक्वल टू समथिंग. That means zero is known as additive identity. Associative property of addition. See, x plus y in brackets plus z is equals to x plus in brackets y plus z. Both are same. Okay. This property is known as associative property of addition. Associative property of addition. We will see associative property of addition. 3 plus 4 in brackets plus 5 is equals to 3 plus 4 plus 5 in brackets. That means the addition of 3 plus 4 is 7 plus 5. Similarly, the addition of 4 plus 5 is equals to 9, 3 plus 9 is equals to 12, and 7 plus 5 is equals to 12. Both are same. This property is known as associative property of addition. Associative property of addition. We will go for the next exercise, exercise 2.2. First sum. Find the sum by suitable rearrangement. 837 plus 208 plus 263. We can add these three numbers like anything, but for simplicity we will add like this: 837 plus 363 plus 208. If we can add these two numbers, we will get 1200 plus 208. Using associative property, we have done this one. Okay, now it is very much simple for us to add 1200 plus 208, that is 1408. This is problem A. Second one, 1962 plus 453 plus 1538 plus 647 can be added as 1962 plus 1538 plus 453 plus 647. We will get, if we can add these two numbers, we will get 3500, and if we can add these two numbers, we will get 1100. If we can add, we will get 4600. We can add them all like anything, but for simplicity, for simplifying the problem, we are doing like this. Okay. Find the product by suitable rearrangement. 2 into 1768 into 50. We can make this as 2 into 50 multiplied with 1768. That means 100 into 1768. That means 1768. Afterwards, we will get two zeros. Okay, this is how we are going to make the products easily. Now, 4 into 166 into 25. We can make this as, tell me students, 4 into 25 into 166. that means 100 into 166, that is 1600, or else we can call it as 16600. Finding the product by making suitable rearrangement. Next one, 8 into 291 into 125. We can make it as 8 into 125 into 291. The value of 8 into 125 is 1000 into 291 means we can add 3 more zeros here. Okay, 291 afterwards 3 zeros, that we can write it as 291,000. Similarly, the next one is 625 into 279 into 16 can be written as 625 into 16 here into 279. That means the value is 10,000 into 279. We will get after 279, we will get 4 zeros. Okay, like this. Next sum is 285 into 5 into 60. We can write it as 5 into 60 into 285. That means 300 into 285. We can make it as, again, this 285 can be written as 300 minus 15, just to make simplifying this problem. My dear students, we can do the sum, we can do the mathematical problem in many number of ways. Okay, one of the way by making simplifying is like this. This 285 can be written as 300 minus 15. Okay, now according to the associative property of subtraction, 300 into 300 minus 300 into 15, that means here it is 90,000 minus 4500, which is equals to 85,500. Like this, we can simplify the very big numbers. Next one is 125 into 40, 8 into 25, all these four numbers. We can rearrange them all as 125 into 8 in brackets into 40 into 25 in brackets. This 125 into 8 can be written as 1000 and 40 into 25 written as 1000. 1000 into 1000 is 10 lakhs. This is how we are going to simplify the problems with the help of suitable rearrangement. Find the value of the following. The first one is 297 into 17 plus 297 into 3. We can write this as 297 taken as common into 17 plus 3. 17 plus 3 is, we can write it as 20, or we can write this as 2 into 10. Okay. 2 into 297 is 594 into 10 is, we can add one more zero, 5940. Okay, or we can directly go for the multiplication of 297 into 20. Instead, we made this 20 as 2 into 10. Have you observed? Further more simplification. Next one, 54279 into 92 plus 8 into 54279, such a very big number. Taking the number 54279 as common into 92 plus 8. Okay, multiplicative associative identity. This 92 plus 8 is equal to 100. We can add two zeros to this number 542790. Next one is 81265 into 169 minus 81265 into 69. So taking once again this very big number as common, 81265 into 169 minus 69, that is equal to 100. We will get two more zeros here, 81265 double zero. Okay. Next one, 3845 × 5 × 782. Okay. Plus 769 × 25 × 218. A little bit complicated problem. So we will see this one. 3845 × 5 × 782. It is remain same, and this will be written as 769 × 5 × 5. This 25 can be written as 5 × 5. 5 × 5. That's all. And this can be, this value can be written as 3845. 769 × 5 is 3845. Now we will take the common, the value of 3845 × 5 × 782 + 218. Observe this one carefully. 3845 × 5, taking as common. Here also it is there. So that 782 + 218. If we can add this one, it is 1000. Simplifying, 5 × 1000, 5000. Okay. This value is 19225. 5 into this one, 19225 × 1000. We can add 3 zeros after 19225. That is 1,92,25,000. Such a very big number, we can make it as very much easily, simplifying it. Find the product using suitable properties. 738 × 103. This 103 can be written as 100 + 3. By using distributive property, 738 × 100 + 738 × 3. That is, we can add 2 zeros here. 738 + 2214. If we can add these two numbers, the value is this much, 76,014. Next one, 854 × 102. This 102 can be written as 100 + 2. If you can observe, again by using the distributive property, 854 × 100 + 854 × 2. This value is simply adding 2 zeros here, and 854 × 2 is 1708. If you can add these two numbers, we get 87,108. Next one, 258 × 1008. This can be written as 1000 + 8. That means, using distributive property, 258 × 1000 + 258 × 8. 258 afterwards 3 zeros plus 2064. If you can add this one, you will get 260,064. The next one is 1005 + 1685. This can be written as 1000 + 5 × 168. Okay, I think this value is type mismatch. This is just only 168. There is no 5. Please observe, my dear students, this is the typing mistake. So this 1005 can be written as 1000 + 5 × 168. That means, by using distributive property, 168 × 1000 + 5 × 168. 168 × 1000 is, after 168 you will get 3 zeros, plus 5 × 168 value is 840. That means, if you can add these two values, if you can add these two numbers, we get this value, 168,840. Next problem, a taxi driver filled his car petrol tank with 40 liters of petrol on Monday. 40 liters of petrol on Monday. The next day, he filled the tank with 50 liters of petrol. Okay, on Monday he filled with 40 liters and the next day with 50 liters of petrol. If the petrol costs 44 rupees per liter, how much did he spend in all on the petrol? We will see. Petrol filled on Monday is equals to 40 liters, right? and the cost of petrol is 44 rupees. That means petrol filled on Tuesday is 40 liters. Therefore, total money spent is equals to 40 into 44 plus 50 into 44, right? If you can take this as a common, 40 plus 50 into 44, this 44 is taken as common. 40, the value of 40 plus 50 is 90. 90 into 44 is equals to 3960 rupees. Okay, this is also same as to that of distributive property. Here we have applied the distributive property of addition. Next one. A vendor supplies 32 liters of milk to a hotel in the morning and 68 liters of milk in the evening. 32 liters of milk in the morning and 68 liters of milk in the evening. If the milk costs 45 rupees per liter, how much money is due per day? Milk supplied in the morning is 32 liters and in the evening is 68 liters. So total supply per day is 100 liters, that is 32 plus 68. But the cost of the milk is 15 rupees per liter. Therefore, the total cost is 15 into 100 per day. That is 15,000 rupees. Okay. Match the following. Students, observe all these things carefully. 425 into 36 is equals to 425 into 6 plus 30 plus 100. So it is distributivity of multiplication over addition. Next one. 2 into 49 into 50 is equals to 2 into 50 into 49. This is commutativity under multiplication. And the third one is 80 plus 2005 plus 20 is equals to 80 plus 20 plus 2005. That is commutativity under addition. Okay. We will see the pattern in whole numbers. Observe this picture carefully. This picture is following some pattern. First one dot, four dots, eight dots, like that. It is following some pattern. If we can link these dots one with other, it is going to follow a picture. Okay. This picture looks like to follow a pattern.